Hello there from a very hot and humid Bulgaria. It's Sunday the 7th of June and yesterday I flew into Sofia where I'm doing a business trip for a week. But that was Saturday, so I've got a full day today, Sunday, to do what I want. And what I've chosen to do is get a train ride to the second biggest city in Sofia, Plovdiv. It's the oldest continuously inhabited city in Europe. There have been inhabitants here for 8,000 years continuously. So they've got loads of stuff to see, but in particular I want to see some of the Roman things. They've got a stadium, a forum, a couple of theatres, aqueducts, all sorts. So I'm going to see what I can see. I've got about 5 hours to do it before my train back. I know I'm doing this out of order, but before I show you any of that, I'm going to show you some of the train right here. The train is crazy. It's quite modern loco, but the carriages look ancient, something out of the Soviet era perhaps. So it's definitely interesting. It was a 3 hour journey and I went first class because the first class only cost £1 more, which brings the total ticket price to £5.50 for 3 hours. That is definitely not English pricing. Someone's stolen the fountain. It's coming back. Anyway, let's go and explore, see what we can see.
After getting the metro from the airport near my hotel, I went into central Sofia and to the station where I grabbed a breakfast which cost next to nothing, and then spent far too long staring at this departure board when I perhaps should have looked above at the psychosocial support that was available. I couldn't work out where I was meant to go, this board didn't seem to display platform numbers in any meaningful way, and this really wasn't helping. After wandering around a bit, I managed to follow a couple of people who looked like they might be going a long distance, and ended up next to the train. The board here was much more helpful. And here it is, this is my train. This is the first class carriage, and then there's a Siemens loco at the front, and then a couple more standard class carriages behind. On board, it was pretty basic, but what I expected. There's a toilet there, we'll come back to that, luckily. And then the carriages themselves are made up of these kind of Harry Potter style compartments. I had a booked seat near the window, took my seat, marvelled at the number of platforms that existed here, even though there were probably only two tracks in use. And we headed off to Plovdiv. All the stations on the way looked in good condition. Some of the buildings just outside the stations were run down. They all had their own station masters to wave the train off. And I think what was quite jolting culturally was watching the people just walking straight across the track. Obviously you would never do this in most of Western Europe, but around here, that's the way you get across. The toilet was perhaps not as scary as the door next to it, which probably should have been closed. I don't know if it was broken or letting air in. But while I was up out of my seat, I took the opportunity to go into the corridor where you can open windows and have a good look out and watch the scenery go by. Being a 3 hour journey, there was plenty of time to take in the sights, watch the world go by and spot for any odd cars like this old Golf. Saw a couple of Trabants as well. Once I got to Plovdiv station, the loco has moved to the other end of the train to head back to Sofia. I did a tiny bit of train spotting. I wasn't alone, there was a little lad there as well filming the train, so it made me feel a bit less conspicuous knowing that I wasn't the only one. The bus into the centre of Plovdiv cost me just one lev, or €50 cents, and it wasn't long before I was near the centre. There are Roman ruins everywhere, but the first place I was particularly interested to see was at the other end of the high street. I always find this level of history hard to comprehend. You know, 2,000 years ago, horses, riders, drivers would have been coming out of here, ready to race. And the crowd looking on. And there's only a small section left. There's this nice mural to kind of give you the impression of what it would have been like chariot racing all those years ago. Genuine Roman drains with genuine water. It's funny what survives, isn't it? I wonder who sat here first. I wonder who'll sit here last. I'm now on my way to the theatre and I was warned two things. Firstly, it's a massive hill to get there, which it's really humid today, but the cooling wind is appreciated. And secondly, it's a bit of a maze and easy to get lost. But it's lovely. It's all the old town. And everybody, look, there's things to see. There's a wedding going on through there. But yeah, onwards and very much upwards. This is a little bit of a disappointment.
It's in such nice shape, this building. It's got to be.
Let's head over to that fence, see what we can see. And what I could see from the fence was actually quite a good view of the theatre. This was meant to be the highlight of the trip, but it was closed. But the reason it was closed was justifiable in my view. So the theatre's closed, which is a shame because I wanted to walk around, but also it shows how it's still in use today. This is all preparation for a concert tonight, they're doing sound checks. You can see the mountains in the distance and that main road goes right underneath through a tunnel. I wish I was staying later now, what a place to watch a concert. Can you imagine who lives at this house on the left? What a view. So I walked a little way around to another gap in the fence, took a look from another viewpoint. I think I got a feel for how it should be. Maybe another time I can come back and have a proper look round. You know there's a lot of Roman stuff when there's just a pile of it. So it's time to leave the massive stadium behind and head back down the hill. I went through the old town, past the wedding again, and onto the high street. So far we'd seen this massive theatre, we'd also seen in the end the massive chariot racing track, but there was one more kind of amphitheatre thing to see. This was the Odeon. Well, I don't think it'll be long before it starts raining. In the town centre, this is part of the Forum, and as you can see if I zoom in, ancient Roman electric scooter. Looking very lonely in the middle of this Roman road. There's not much of it left, but this was a library. Interesting how they know it's a library. And here's the last stop on our tour of Rome and Plovdiv, the Odeon. I guess it's just a smaller theatre. Got a stage here, some columns behind it. Yeah, right, I'm gonna get some food. I'll get back to the station. The train on the way back looked very similar from the outside, but inside, it couldn't have been more different. Instead of the individual compartments, it was a more standard seating layout. And in first class, this was a 1+2 configuration. And I had my own little window seat with a table. I say window, it wasn't exactly see-through. My views on the way home were not going to be quite as good as they were when I came out. And the journey certainly wasn't going to be as smooth either. This was a rattly old thing. And while I wasn't going to have a good view, at least my camera did. I could just about poke it outside the window and get some footage, being very careful not to drop it. That's the end of my journey today. I've just got to get back to the airport. I'll get to train all to myself by the looks of it. Unlike everybody else who got off. Try that again. The reason everyone was on the other side was because that's the route into Sofia. That train does pretty much every stop on that line, whereas the way I went is the way to the airport, which is just two stops. That's why it was a bit biased, and I had
much more quiet journey than everyone else. Anyway, all I need to do now is get on the shuttle bus to the hotel, and I'm done for the day, and I could redo the rest. I've done like, someone else is worried about missing it. I've done about 20,000 steps today. It's been very hot and humid, but lots of fun. Worth the adventure, and tomorrow I've got to go to work. So, hope you enjoyed the video. See you all later. Why do the buses sound like American level crossings?